صلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، بيستو حديث عن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: لا تلقوا الركبان ولا يبع حاضر لبعد، لا تلقوا الركبان ولا يبع حاضر لبعد. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, don't go out to meet caravans, and no town man is permitted to sell things on behalf of a man from the desert. One of the narrator of the hadith, Tabi'i, his name is Tawus. He's not Sahabi Tabi'i. He's a student of Abdullah ibn Abbas. He asked Abdullah ibn Abbas, what is the meaning وَلَا يَبْعَ حَاضِرْ لِبَادْ؟ Abdullah ibn Abbas he asked Tawus, what did he mean, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by saying no townsman is permitted to sell on behalf of a Bedouin? He replied, he should not be a broker for him. This hadith muttafaq alayh. Another narration in Muslim, Sahih Muslim, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا تلقوا الجلب فمن تلقي فاشتري منه فإذا أتى سيده السوق فهو بالخيار. Don't go out to meet what is being brought. If one is met and some of his goods are sold, then when the owner arrives at the city or the market, he has the choice. What is the meaning of this hadith? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا تلقوا الركبان. It means, usually people come to the city to sell their goods. Okay, for example, I am from Mecca. Okay, why I like to come to Kuwait, or don't say from Mecca, before, people from Iraq come to Kuwait to sell the dates. It is known that they have a lot of dates, or the drinking water. Okay. What some people do from Kuwait city, they go to the border, for example, or they go outside the city to buy from the Iraqi trader. Why? Because he doesn't want that trader who's traveling, coming to Kuwait, he doesn't want him to know the price inside the city. So, for this, the one who's coming, for example, from Iraq or from Saudi, okay, he has, for example, 100 kilos of dates. And if you tell him, okay, I will give you, for example, 50 KD for 100 kilos. He'll come not only happy, very happy. Why? Because how much the cost of the dates? Okay, maybe for 1 kilo, 100 fils. So for 100 kilo, how much? 10 KD. I'm giving you 50 KD. He'll be crazy. Okay, but when I buy from him and I come to the city, how much I will sell? 1 KD. For each kilo, 1 KD. So what's the price? 100. Okay. If this man who's coming from Saudi or from Iran, if he knows that, if he walks for example, 1 or 2 hours, and the price will be double, what will happen? He will not sell to me. صح? Okay. So in this case, the harm on the tradesman. He will lose his money, haram, because the price of the city, like this. Or, what will happen? Okay, this man, he is a farmer. His farm dates or any type. So if the cost is 100 fils, he will be satisfied if he sell 300 fils for 1 kilo. and he has maybe 200, 300 kilos. He will be more than satisfied if he sells 400 fish. Okay? But I go to him, why? Why 400 fills? You should sell 700 fills, 1 kd for each kilo. So in this case, what will happen to the people of the city? Okay. They will suffer. Why we should pay more? Khalas, don't go to him. Let this man sell the what is enough for him. So the scholar said, subhanAllah, what is the wisdom behind this, from this hadith? Because they want the benefit for the trade, the traders, and also they want the benefit for the people in the city. Yani, subhanAllah, this is the Sharia. Okay, yani the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all the Sharia cares about the people, the city, the market. Okay, but now people don't care. Yeah, greedy. They will suck the blood, the money from your blood, subhanAllah. Yeah, look how the mercy of the Sharia. Khalas, let people, Allah will give the risk from people to other people. And now, this happens now. Yeah, for example, you have a flat. Okay, you want rent. You want to gain money. Okay. For you, it is enough for you 200 KD monthly. If it is 220, 250, this is more than enough. But for example, if I have an office and you want to put your flat in my office, Abdul-Adr, how much you want for this flat? You say, okay, between 200 to 250. Are you crazy? Now the rent is 500 KD. Yani for him it's okay, but subhanAllah, the problem of some people, they try to make, why? Because the office will take more if you make the rent more. So the first part of the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, don't go outside the city or on the border of the city, okay, to buy from the travelers and the traders. And the second part of the hadith, وَلَا يَبَعْ حَاضِرْ لِبَادْ. يعني don't work for him. خلاص, let him come inside the city, then he sells his goods. And this is very important in the Sharia. The next hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, نهى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أن يبيع حاضر لباد ولا تناجشوا ولا يبيع الرجل على بيع أخي. Okay. The first two parts of the hadith, we spoke about them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited that a city dweller sells on behalf of a man from the desert, and we spoke about this. The second also, and ordered not to bid against one another. We mentioned this, wala tanajashu, najash, najsh. If there is an auction, okay, you try to increase the price of the item. We spoke about this last ders. The third one, wala yabi'u al-rajul ala bay'i akhi. No man should outbid the selling of his brother. Now there is something called khiyar majlis, the choice if you are in the same sitting, in the same place. Okay, I bought from you your mobile. I bought the mobile of Abu Fatma. How much? 50 KD. Okay. Then after 5 minutes, one of the brother came. Okay. For example, Brother Saeed came, and I told him. Okay, or he saw my mobile, from where this mobile? Well, I bought this mobile from Abu Fatma. How much? 50 KD. Then he said, okay, I have the same mobile, but 45 KD. So I will sell you my mobile. Okay, during this time, we are in the same halqa, we are in the same place. I have the right to to reply the return the mobile. And also he has, Abu Fatma has the right to return the money. I mean, both of us has the right to cancel. So now, what will happen? The same mobile, but 5K dealers. Abu Fatma, I don't khalas. I don't want your mobile here. Take, and you should give me the money. This is my right to return. But it is haram. It is haram for Saeed. وَلَا يَبِعْ بَعْضُكُمْ عَلَى بَيْعْ بَعْضٍ. And now, why he lost this business transaction? Because of somebody else. So this is haram. And also, if it is buying, okay, the same example, I bought this mobile from Abu Fatma 50KD. Then Saeed came and he said to Abu Fatma, where is your mobile? He said, well, just before 5 minutes I sold to Abu Abdurrahman, to me. How much? 50. He said, I pay you 60KD. Also, this is haram. So buying or selling, both of them, haram. This is not allowed.
So this case applies to the market also, like if I bought a mobile for 50KD, okay, then I paid the money, then I went to the next shop, I found for 40KD. So I can't go back to the first shop, I said, no, I don't want it, to return it, and go and buy from the second shop?
Look, in this situation, when you bought the mobile from the first shop, and you left the shop,
yes,
this case, khalas. It's finished. It's up to him. If he likes to return, it's up to him, not up to you. So in this case, okay, this happens, subhanAllah. So you can go to the shop, and maybe not the same day, maybe next day. Please, I want to return this mobile. If they say, okay, khalas, it's okay. And also, another thing. In some shops, they give you, for example, 2 weeks. You have 14 days. It is your right to return. Okay. This case, in your situation, also this is allowed. Why? Because you found a good price. Nobody showed you the first one. Maybe you bought the mobile yesterday. And today you showed us the mobile and you said, I bought this 190KD. So one of the brothers told you, but no. In Salmiya, for example, there's a shop is doing an offer. It is 150. He's not working in the shop. He's one of your friends. So he told you that there is an offer. So now, can you go to your shop and you return? Yes, you can. Because the hadith is talking about
same place.
A person who's doing this. Okay, to broke the first one. Also, some scholars, I think Sheikh Mu'taymin or some scholars, they said, if somebody bought something, you bought the mobile, okay, you bought Samsung S7, how much? 170KD. And you come today. However, then you showed us the mobile, you said, well, I bought this 170. So one of the brothers, or maybe two, or we say, why 170? It should be 160. That place, it is 160. So we start to blame you. Okay? Even some people said, no need. Khalas. Okay, for a mobile, the price is, let's say, 200. If the difference is 5KD, or 7KD, or 10KD, so, is it a big difference to the price? It's not a big difference. Don't make your friend sad because of 5 or 6 or more or less. Khalas. Because this is his risk, subhanAllah. This is risk. If you want to check every single person, no doubt you'll find differences. So leave them. But if there is a big difference, for example, he bought the mobile 200KD, and the price is 140, it's a big difference. يعني more than a quarter. So he says, yes, no, you can go and you speak to the if you can return, return.
But
Banyan
selling is not allowed in the masjid, right?
Yes, yes. We did not buy anything. We did not buy anything.
Examples.
It is only example, yes. It is not allowed to buy or sell in the masjid. It is not. We did not buy anything. And we don't, yes. They don't know we are in a masjid.
In West, people usually they return the goods after using it. Mm. Because there is a time to return.
Mm.
So they take it and just use it and return it back. So it is allowed or not? It is not a good habit.
Well, it depends on the shop. Okay, shops know that people use them.
In America, it's common.
Huh?
In America, it's common.
Very common.
Okay, but they know that people use them. Cameras, But if there is a condition that you should not use this item, okay. But usually people know that. Yeah, for example, they give you 14 days camera or a watch. Of course, people will use them.
Yeah.
They will use them. But sometimes they mention a condition to, yani, it should be new. How? Yani, you want to buy a gift to your friend or to your wife, anyone. Okay. So when you return, it is inside the box. So it is clear, it is not used.
But tension from the start is like only you buy it, you use it and return it back. Then tension is back from the beginning. So this is maybe not allowed, you know. You're not buying it, you're just buying it to, because you don't have it, so you just want to use it for 1 hour for something. Especially swing machines, people buy it. Swing one cloth,
swing? Swing?
The swing machines? Yeah. The stretching?
Yeah.
Very common in this West. Yeah.
And I mean the owner know this.
They know, yeah, because they the know. Market is so competitive, they say fine.
Okay.
He might keep it, you know, like this.
Okay. If they know, they okay, خلاص. Okay, but I mean the owner of the shop. He knows that some people doing this.
Yeah, they know.
It is not all people, some people.
Yeah, some people.
And that's why he did not cancel this condition.
But for me as a buyer, if I have this intention that I'll use it and I'll return it back.
Well, okay, why they give you this option?
Yeah.
Because some people like the item and they change their intention.
Yeah.
Yes, some people.
If I have this intention, I'll use things and give them back.
صح.
This is wrong. And
like even for mobile, I'll take a mobile just to show my friend, you know, I have the latest mobile. And then I'll go afterwards and return it. And then make excuse that it's not a good mobile.
Well, in this case, he's lying. Okay. Allah alam about this intention. But I mean the point, people know, I mean the people who are working the shop, they know that some people, they take only to use for a few days.
Like it mainly happens more on GPS, you know, on this tracker. They put in the car, go to anywhere.
They travel 2-3 days and come. Allah alam. Okay. The next hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من فرق بين والدة وولدها فرق الله بينه وبين أحبتي يوم القيامة. If anyone separates a mother and her child, Allah will separate him from his beloved ones on the day of resurrection. Another hadith around this meaning, عن علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله تعالى عنه narrated, the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم commanded me, he said, the Prophet ﷺ commanded me to sell two slaves, young brothers. So I did, but I separated them. When I mentioned this to the Prophet ﷺ, he said, search for them and bring them back and don't sell them except to the same person. So in these two ahadith, the Prophet talk about selling the slaves. The first one, the Prophet ﷺ said, if you separate the mother from her child. And the next hadith talk about the brothers. So some scholars said, if there is relation, don't separate. Yeah, like the mother and the child, or the brother, his sister, or his brother. Even some scholars said, this is not only for the slaves, also for the animals. Subhanallah, yes, also for the animals. Okay, yani, you have a newborn camel and his mother. If you want to sell, sell both of them. Don't sell, for example, the baby, the young camel with the she camel. Okay, yeah. Look, this is the Sharia. Subhanallah. The next hadith.
Sheikh, if the camel is not feeding, then it's separate.
Well, as I said, yeah, some scholars said even for the animals. And they are talk about the young, maybe newly born, maybe four or five days like this. Why you separate them? Let them together.
After it is independent, you can
serve. Yes, this is a different issue. This is a different issue. Also, the same thing in the slaves. If they are not young boys, if they are adult, more than puberty, you can separate them. Because they don't need also the same thing, the mother and the son. Some scholars said like this. The next hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sorry, the Sahaba came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, and Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala an said the prices went up in Medina during the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. People asked him. They asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, O Messenger of Allah, the prices went up, so please fix the prices for us. And we want a law from you to fix the price. The price is going up. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Inna Allah wal musa'ir al-qabd al-basit al-raziq. Allah is the one who fixes the prices. Al-musa'ir. He is the restrainer. He is the one who gives generously. The sublime sustainer. And I wish to me to meet Allah, the Almighty, with none of you having any claim on me for any injustice regarding blood or property. The Sahaba complained to the Prophet ﷺ, the prices went up. So please fix the prices. Yani, tell them to limit, give them limits. Alaykum salam. Then the Prophet ﷺ mentioned four names of Allah: Al Musa'ir, Al Qabid, Al Basit, Al Raziq. Okay, these are names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Allah, he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, in Allah, huwa al-musa'ir, who fixes the prices. Okay. Why Hafiz ibn Hajar put this hadith here? To talk about the issue, can we force the business people to fix the price or not? Okay. From this hadith, this is not allowed. From this hadith, it is not allowed. Okay, but some scholars said, like Shaykh Islam Taymiyyah Ibn Qayyim, okay, they said this hadith talks about a situation when the prices went up because the people need this item more, or this item became less in the country. Yani, for example, if usually they bring, for example, the food, or for example, in Kuwait, they bring the rice from India. Okay, and we have we know, for example, the kilo from 1 kg to 2 kg. But now there is a problem in India. Okay, they have earthquake something. So now it is difficult to bring the rice to Kuwait. So normally what will happen in these, like these situations? The price will go up. Okay? So in this case, it is not allowed for the emir, I mean the king or the leader of the country, the ruler, it is not allowed for him to say to the people, no, don't go beyond this price. Khalas. It is only between 1 KD to 2 KD. It is not allowed to sell 2 KD. Okay, but now there is a problem in India. Usually we bring for 1 kilo, half KD, 600 fils. So our profit, about half KD. From half KD to 1 KD. But now we need to pay maybe 3 KD for each kilo to bring. And you want us to sell the same price? What will happen? Huh? If the government told you this, what you will do? You'll stop selling the rice. Khalas, I will not bring this rice. So they said Ibn Qayyim, okay, Sheikh Islam Taymiyyah, they said if the price went up because of something, yani, not in the control of the people, okay, then you are not allowed to fix a price for them. But if the situation is the same, we are bringing the rice from India and they did not raise the price, but the business people here, the greedy people here, they agreed, why we are selling only 1 KD? Let's make it 3 KD. And all the people who sell the rice, yeah, usually in the country, usually, where is the source of the rice? Maybe one person or two, صح? خلاص, they agree, خلاص, we'll put this price. يعني, from where the people will buy? Okay, all the jam'iyyah, all the shops, I mean the small shops, they buy from only these two owners. If these two owners agree that this is the price, khalas, 3 KD, what will happen? Khalas, of course. So in this case, no, the hakim, Wuzar Tijara, here for example, the ruler is like Minister of Tijara, of business. No, in this case, they have the right to stop them or to put limits for them. Why? Because they raised the price because of greedy, not because of the demand and the problem. Okay. So this is about this hadith. Next hadith, also related about this hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لا يحتكر إلا خاطئ, رواه مسلم. No one monopolizes except that he is a sinner. Ihtikar, what is the meaning of ihtikar? I'm taking more than one book. But this issue is important because many people misunderstand the concept of ihtikar. They think that ihtikar, if you buy any item from the market and you keep it, okay, then after some time you sell. The situation is not like this for any item. Okay. Ihtikar, some scholars said, ihtikar is to keep the food at your store. For example, you are a businessman, at your store until the price goes up. Okay? Then you sell. If the people need, and you don't need this food. Okay. Another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the first one in Sahih Muslim. Another narration, not in Sahih Muslim, in other books, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, من دخل في شيء من أسعار المسلمين ليغليه عليهم فإن حقا على الله تبارك وتعالى أن يقعده بعظم من النار يوم القيامة. Okay. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if someone entered the market to buy something to make its price higher, then yani Allah will punish him. The Prophet mentioned something that he will give him a seat in the hellfire. Wal-iyadu billah. Okay. Ibn Qudama said about lihtikar. He said lihtikar is haram if there are three conditions. Number one, if you buy the item, yani when the ihtikar is haram, if you buy, okay, not if you bring something from outside. Also, it is not if you manufacture something. You are doing the thing. So now, ihtikar, we are talking that you are a rich man, a businessman, you buy this type of food from the country. We are not talking about bringing something from outside, or you are producing this. Okay, so this is very important. So you buy something from the market, then you keep it. You keep it. And the condition number two, أن يكون المشترى قوتا. يعني what you buy is قوت. What does it mean قوت? It means the type of food people used to store. Like what? Like the rice, like sugar, like the salt. Okay? عدس دال. Okay? شنو عدس من قليزي؟ دال بالأردو.
Beans.
Okay? So, people used to store dates. So, it is not talking about everything. And some scholars said, no, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا يحتكر. إلا خاطئ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who's doing this, خاطئ. He's a sinner. Food or not food. So some scholars said, we are talking about the food that people store, and other scholars said, no, this is general hadith. The Prophet ﷺ did not specify. So if anything people need, so maybe not food, maybe it is cement. No, I mean cement for the constructions. Wood or a type of bricks. Okay, so anything people need. Okay, this is number two. Number three, أن يضيق على الناس بشرائه. Okay, يعني to make the life difficult for people if you buy this item. يعني, for example, if I go now to the جمعية here, the small جمعية, and I buy all the types of rice he has. Okay, and I keep the rice in my car. I took the rice to my home. This is halal or haram? No problem. Why? Because simply, if the people come to the jam'iyyah, they don't find the rice, what they will do? They will go to the big jam'iyyah. Okay, or if I go to the big jam'iyyah here in Hattin and I buy all the rice, maybe 100 kilos or 200 kilos. What the people will do? They will go to Shuhada Jam'iyyah, they will go to Salmiyyah Jam'iyyah, they will go to Hawali Jam'iyyah. So we are not talking about that you are buying the item and no harm on people. No, but if somebody, okay, say, bought the whole rice from the whole Jam'iyyah in Kuwait, this is the situation. Because if he bought from the old Jam'iyyah in Kuwait, from where we can buy? He went to the old Jam'iyyat. He went to the big markets like Lulu, Hyper City, these things, and Safeco. He went to the big markets and he bought the rice. By this action, he will affect the market. He will affect the people. So this is haram. So not any buying, it is haram. No, if he's affecting people, he is making life difficult for them to find this item. So this is the يعني احتكار. It is haram, as we said, if he bought from the country, and also if he bought everything to make the life difficult for people. Then it is haram. But as I said, if he if he bought something available in another place, no problem. And also there is something important, if the people need this item. Yeah, and for example, you bought all types, all the Samsung 7 mobiles from the market. You went to Al-Ghanim, you went to Eureka, you went to the small shops, and you bought all Samsung 7. What is the problem? No problem. Because this will not affect people. Okay, they will become sad, but they will go to Samsung 6, they will go to iPhone, to Huawei. Okay. So we here the scholars talk about something affect their Muslim society, affecting people, something important in their life. Okay. So this is the haram ihtikar. Okay. There is an issue here. If you buy for yourself, look, you are not buying to make the prices higher. You are buying for yourself. No, I want to buy 50 kilos of rice. I want to keep for my family. Okay. Okay, 50. Okay, usually you need only 5 kilos a month. You are only 3 or 4 persons at home. No, I want to keep this for 1 year. Can we say no? You are muhtakir. This is haram. No, this is allowed. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did this. Hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. Okay, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to save the food for his family for 1 year. And he used to buy the food for 1 year. So this is allowed. Why? Because he's keeping this for him, for his family. Not to change the prices, to make the prices going up in the market. So now it is, inshallah, it is clear that because some people know why he's doing ihtikar. Why this man is doing ihtikar? Okay. Why is doing ihtikar? Because there is a kind of mobiles not found except in his shop. Don't say this is ihtikar. Khalas. This is not important. It is our. No, I like this type of mobile. Okay, but it's not something important in your life. Ihtikar, if there is something important, like the main food in the country, as we mentioned, this rice or something like the cement for building houses, something important in the country, and you cannot find this in another place in the country, then it is haram. But something optional, then you say he's doing ihtikar. No, please don't say he's doing ihtikar. Next hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La tusarru al-ibil wal-ghanam." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, don't tie up the udders of camels and sheep. Whoever buys such an animal has the option after milking them, either to keep it or to return it to the owner, along with one sa' of dates. And another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said he has choice 3 days. This is a type of ghash, a type of cheating. Okay, some people they have camels, sheep, and also the scholar said the same thing for cows. Okay, usually if they want a she camel, what they look for? If she has a lot of milk. Okay. So if I am the owner and I want to buy this tomorrow, sorry, I want to sell my camel, my she camel tomorrow, I tell my servant or my son, don't take the milk today. Keep the milk inside. Why? Because tomorrow it shows the people that it has a lot of milk. So when you come to buy from me, you think that the daily amount of milk like this. Okay? So you'll be, mashallah, 10 liters of milk. So now you buy. Okay? You go home and you take the milk, mashallah, 10 liters. And usually 7 liters, but mashallah, 10 liters, you are happy. So now you think that daily this camel will give you 10 liters, for example. So mashallah, when you buy today, you took 10 liters. Tomorrow, 5 liters. After tomorrow, okay, 5. What is the problem? He is cheating. So you will know from the first day. So now the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells you, you have the option. Now you have the choice. What choice I have? If you like, you keep this she camel with you. Khalas, forget. Allah will give you, inshallah, the akhirah. And he is cheating. Or you have the right to return the she camel. And what? One sa' of date. Sa', it is like zakat al-fitr. Yani, almost two and quarter kilos. Okay, something like this. Yani, between scholars, between 2 and 3 kilos. Okay. Why I should give back the sa'? Because I used the milk. Okay, I used the milk. Okay, but I did not use the daily milk. I used the more than daily milk. Okay. Some scholars said no. Why we give one sa' khalas? You give this camel. You return the camel and you take the money without anything extra. He said, look, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you want to return, give one sa' khalas. Okay, now the question, one sa' is equal to the milk you took? Of course not equal. Not equal. But this is a hukum, this is a rule from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we have to follow. Don't discuss, khalas. Okay, I return the money with one sa'. Why one sa'? Why one sa'? Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said one sa'. That's it. Yani, some scholars discuss this. Why one sa'? And it is not equal to. Please, it is equal or not equal. But this is the haq. This is the right. The problem when some scholars trying to discuss why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said this. Okay. خلاص, the Prophet ﷺ has the right to give exceptions. You like to keep with you. You want to return, خلاص, this is your choice, but you have 3 days. Don't come after 1 week. You said, no, I want to return. Okay, why you did not return from the first day or second or third? Because خلاص, it will be clear from the first day. If not the first day, the second day. But you are coming after 1 week. No, the Prophet ﷺ gave you three days. Because also, subhanAllah, the Sharia doesn't want people to play. Okay, yes, I am cheating you. But also, you don't cheat me again. Look, the justice in Sharia, you will not find this justice in any religion, like the Sharia. And also, you cannot find the justice in the laws of people, written by people, subhanAllah.
He can put this condition.
But in this case, he's cheating. He's cheating. Okay, yani, okay. You bought a car, and you say, yeah. For example, you bought a car from me. Okay. Then you said, okay, Abu Abdurrahman, I want khiyar 3 days. What does it mean khiyar? Yani, the choice to return the car 3 days. I want to see the car. I want to check the car. Then I said, no, please. If you want to buy, khalas, buy. Without any choice. Look, it is his right to put the 3 days, and also it is my right to refuse. Maybe later I accept his choice, the 3 days, or I refuse and he accepts my condition that khalas, if you buy now, don't return. So now, if he agreed on my condition that I will not accept returning the money, then after 1 day or 2 days, Okay, for example, after using the car, he discovered that this car is not 2015, it is 2014. Okay, for people, this is a small difference or a major thing. This is a major. Okay, it is a major. So in this case, he can't return. Can I say no, khalas, you put a condition? No, I cannot say this, because this is a different story. Because maybe I am cheating, or maybe I don't know. Maybe he said, Abu Abdurrahman, you told me it is 2015, but it is 2014. Oh, I forgot. No, it's not acceptable. Khalas, I should return in this case, if he wants. Or I can give him back the difference. Yeah, for example, if the difference 300 KD, I should pay him 300 KD, not the full price. Okay. So there is something called khiyar al aib. Okay, there is a special chapter about the khiyar. What's mean khiyar al aib? Yani if you discover that there is a defect in the car or in the mobile, خلاص, you have the one who bought it has the right to return it back. And there is something called khiyar al-shart. What's mean khiyar al-shart? That if you put a condition, I have 3 days option. During these 3 days, I have the choice to return back. Khalas. This is called khiyar al-shart. You put a condition. And there is something called khiyar al-majlis. Okay? During the same sitting, you have the right to return. This is called khiyar al-majlis. If we are in one sitting. Okay, there is a special chapter about khiyar. Okay, alhamdulillah, this is in Sharia. This is in Sharia. This is an advantage of Sharia. And, remember that people can cheat. Yani, look, the rules of Sharia cannot control all types of people. What can control everything? Taqwa Allah. The fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if there is no fear of Allah, people can escape from the rules. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam knows this. He said, "Innama ana bashar, wa innakum tahtakimun alay." I am a human being. I don't know the ghaib. I don't know the unseen. Innakum tahtakimun alay. You come to me as a judge, and I listen to your proofs. And the Prophet said, وَبَعْضُكُمْ أَلْحَمْ بِحُجَّتِهِ مِنْ بَعْضِ. Some people, mashallah, they have very nice style in talking. So maybe they take the right of other people because of their style. Okay, in this case, the Prophet said, so I will give you the rule, the hukum. خلاص, this thing will be for you. But if you are if this is not your right, khalas, it means it is a piece of fire. Okay, so some people become happy if they own something or they win something, even by the wrong way. They say, no, they gave me this, but you know this is haram. This is your problem. Don't say, no, it is their problem. No, this is your problem. Yeah. For example, if your job, your company or your ministry, okay, put in your account money. Okay. This happens. In Kuwait, for example, in April or in May, in June, they give the a'mal mumtaza. She's someone bonus. Okay, and the ministries, they give the bonus, and you are sure that I'm not supposed to take the bonus this year. Why? Because there are rules. If you have a vacation more than 100 days, khalas, it is impossible to take. And you took a vacation 200 days or 120. And they put this in your account, and you are sure this is not your right. You are sure it is by mistake. And you went and you check. You went to the ministry, or you call the ministry and you ask them, can you give this the bonus if I am on leave more than 100 days? They say, no, this is impossible. And if this happened, this is by mistake. Then your friends say, why you tell them? So let's take the money. You did not ask the money, and you did not steal the money. They put the money in your account. Khalas, it is their mistake. Is it allowed? Ah. Why? Because you know this is not your right. And this happened because of a mistake from one person. Or maybe it is not a mistake. Maybe the employee, muhasib, he put this in your account because he wants money from you. Can this happen? Is this happen? Happening? I think this is happening. Okay? Khalas, Abdul Qadir, I'll put this money for you, but you give me 50-50. So which is better? You get nothing or you get half? Half is better, صح? For many people, they think, they believe this is okay. Wallahi, yani, subhanAllah, you notice some practice among the Muslims as if they are not Muslims. Wallahi, strange. Wallahi, strange. Habibi, this is haram. Haram, this is haram. This money for those people who worked, who attend the meeting. This money for people who work after more shift, for overtime. But you are not working overtime. You are going even before your time. Why you are taking this money? No, I'll register. Well, I heard this many times. Register your name, yalla. And you will take the money. Register your name that you attend or you work after the 2 p.m. Wallahi, strange. Okay, so as I mentioned, if there is taqwa, if there is fear of Allah, inshallah, Allah will help you and you not take the haram. Even if the people put the haram in your account. But if there is no taqwa, you will search for the haram. Allah musta'an. Jazakum Allah khair, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Ma'am? Regarding, for example, the note 7, an example, I have bought note 7 and I know that the battery capacity is good. It can last me for 2 days. So. And then the company says, no, there's a problem and recalls all the mobiles and says, give back. But for me, I have no problem with the mobile and I want to keep it. Okay. So it's my right, I can keep the mobile. I don't need to return it because I purchased it. And I know the risk that it can explode.
Mm.
But now the company, what it does is it sends an update and it says, okay, now your battery will not charge full, it's only 50% charge. So is this allowed from the company side that they can control the device? Because I bought it based on the fact that it charges for 2 days and I'm happy with it.
Mm.
But because of some problem with the mobile, it explodes and all
that. Okay, you accepted the mobile with the problem.
My device doesn't have a problem, but the rest in general, it has a problem and they recalled all, they said to give it back.
Okay.
But since I did not give it back, they are trying to control saying, okay, this is the upgrade and it will be only 50% charge. So now they have violated this condition.
They are trying to control
just to be on the safe side, they said that this is the upgrade which your battery will now charge only 50%.
So you said...
Yes, for myself. But my device does the company has the right to do this? To control my device to charge only 50%?
Why they are doing this?
Because they want to protect Samsung also. Samsung, the image. So
okay. In general, this will affect the company name, صح? Why? Because okay, they don't want this risk, and they gave you the option. Khalas, return the mobile back, and we'll give you the new one, صح? Or we give you the money.
Yeah, but I'm happy with the mobile. I don't want to return because it doesn't have a problem.
Yeah, look, sorry, I forgot to explain one issue in the hadith about tas'ir, about fixing the price. The Prophet sallallahu, I forget this. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said at the end of the hadith, وَإِنِّي لَأَرْجُوا أَنْ أَلْقَى اللَّهُ وَلَيْسَ أَحَدٌ مِنْكُمْ يَطْلُبُنِي بِمَظْلَمَةٍ. The Prophet ﷺ said, and I wish to meet Allah, the Almighty, with none of you having any claim on me for any injustice regarding blood or property. Okay. Why he mentioned this, or what is the relation with the beginning of the hadith and the end of the hadith? Because the Prophet ﷺ, usually people talk about the business people, the traders. They are greedy. But also the Prophet ﷺ wants to be justice with them and also with the people. Why? Because if he fixed the price, okay, this will harm them. Why? Because they paid a lot of things to bring this item. So the Prophet ﷺ, when the Sahaba told the Prophet ﷺ, please fix the price for us, they want the benefit of the general people or the traders? The people, okay? But the Prophet ﷺ said, no, I cannot, I don't want. Why? Because also I want to protect them. Also, the trader. So, these traders also have rights. So in this case, why they are doing this? Because they want to protect their name, sah? Okay? Why they want to put limits for you? Okay, because they want people, maybe you are not the only person. There, because how many, for example, Samsung 7, they sold in the world? Maybe million. 3, 4, 5 million, sah? And how many are happy with the mobile? So maybe 100,000, 200,000, sah? Yeah, let's say maybe 1%, but it's too much mobile. So maybe after 1 or 2 years, what will happen? This will affect them. This will affect their name. So that's why they are doing this. Yani we cannot stop them. Yani if there is something protecting them. So also the business people have their right to. Their right.
Regarding the cement, you know that some rich people go for highest quality cement, quality number one. Quality number one is in demand in the market. So then one trader has his sole distribution authority, he is holding it. But there are plenty of cement available, quality 2, quality 3, quality 4. So it is catering to the mass public. So
if this does not affect the people, خلاص.
Only rich people.
The problem from them. The problem from the rich people. Okay. No, if it is affecting the people, the general people. يعني for example, there is organic eggs in the market. Okay, yeah. if we buy all the organic eggs, and then people cannot eat the organic eggs, but we have the normal eggs, خلاص. Or buy a chicken and put the chicken at home and get the eggs from there. It is not a problem. Yes.
Can we buy gold and keep?
Yes, you can. Keep the gold, but give the zakah.
Yeah, but careful of Modi now.
No problem.
No problem. I think there's a hadith that this is not to hold. And
right. Sorry?
Not to hold.
It will affect you more.
Yeah, and you store?
There's no limit for.
This is in the Quran. الذين يكنزون الذهب والفضة ولا ينفقون في سبيل الله. Okay. If you keep the gold with you, okay, stocks. And you are not spending this in fi sabilillah and sake of Allah. But it means if you are not giving the zakah. But if you are giving the zakah, khalas.
Can we keep, for example, Ramadan festival is coming. Now itself we are buying clothes and keeping it. It's okay, just take
it. You buy what?
For the Ramadan, the festival, the Eid.
Okay.
So some people start planning from now. Not planning. They don't want to last minute rush. They plan, say, five new shirts, five new frocks. That's it. They will buy and keep and store. Is it okay before 1 year?
What is the problem?
No problem.
What is the problem? Maybe this is better. Why? Because if you buy now, you will be free in Ramadan to stay in the masjid.
Yes. The rice, the new crops, usually when it comes. It's
comparatively
cheaper than the rice when it is all the 1 year old.
All the
they keep it 1 year.
More bitter quality, yeah.
They keep it for. They stock it. They stock it for 1 year. Then they sell it. They stock it for to get the quality gets better.
No problem. No problem. Why? Because they will sell you from the last 2 years. They keep the new one for after 1 year or 2 years. And they will sell the old one. It is working. No, his intention not to affect the, not to make the price higher. His intention is to get more quality. Like the dhun'ud, like I think also types of cheese.
Some of these things.
For example, the Parmesan cheese, there are three qualities or something, number one, number two. The best one is when they keep it more.
Sheikh, in Saudi, they have got one warehouse where they have stocked everything like carnation milk and all. And what they do is with some liquid, they remove the expiry date and they have a machine and they put new expiry date in the service.
Clear cheating. Also medicine. This is clear cheating.
I take one more question regarding gold. Since now, you know, the market goes up and down the prices, and some of the traders, like, they bought gold when it was very expensive. And the market price is now, it's gone down. So there are some people in the market, like, for example, Sukh Samia, they all decided in Sukh Samia that we will sell for a higher price than what is in the market. And for example, me, I don't know. And I go and I buy for the higher price. And then later on, I come to know that this is not the market price. And then I go back to this person and I say, you know, this is not the market price. And I want to give it back. He said, okay, we will buy it, but we will buy it at the market price. So is this allowed?
Did they do this?
It is happening right now. Because just yesterday I asked this thing. And they
said, usually they will not do this with gold.
Yesterday I asked them.
And they can't look. They cannot. Why? Because they cannot. Why? Because when you go to the gold shops, okay, all of them, there is TV and they are watching the number, the price of the gold, minute by minute. So how can they raise the price of gold?
You cannot raise it because market is controlled by that.
Difficult.
I'm talking about the gold and jewelry. I'm talking about the gold coins.
Gold coin.
Okay, this is, it means this is pure gold, pure.
He told me if you want to buy, you buy.
What is the price? What is the price? He will not give more than the market.
No, it is more than the market.
How much? Yani, how? Yani, 200 twills, 300 twills?
No, 2 kd more than that.
200 kd? 2 kd?
2 kd more than
no, this is impossible.
As a whole. 100 gram, 400 gram.
Per gram.
No, this is impossible. Per gram? Impossible.
The gold, there is different carat, right? 18 to 24 carat. Definitely the different prices.
But usually I think the coins 21 carat.
24.
Sorry, yes. 24.
Coins are 22.
Okay, so for 1 gram, for example, it is 14 kd, and then the other...
For example, yesterday, or when I asked him, he said it is 10 and a half, but they are selling it for 11 kd.
11?
The market price is 10 and a half, but we are selling for 11 kg.
He told you this?
Somewhere else, you know, you don't have to buy from them. Maybe he's...
Yeah, but me as a buyer, and they have all decided in soup, that all the shops have decided that they will sell for 11 kg, whereas outside it is all, it's 10 and a half. No, but I as a buyer don't know what is, because for me this is close by, so I go here and I want to buy. But then later on when I come to know that this is not the market price, in the city they are selling for 10 and a half. So when I go back, he said, no, we will buy now market.
Did you make sure they are doing this? Because this is difficult.
I asked the person who's in the gold shop. He's a friend of mine.
Yeah.
He doesn't have coins, but he's...
Because look, the price of the gold is worldwide. Not only
points because of this issue, because they buy at a higher price.
Today we should go and check in the city and Samia.
I'm not talking jewelry. I'm talking coins.
You are talking about the pure gold.
Yes.
Pure gold. Look, if there is a big difference, yani for example, for 1 gram, the difference is half kd. But if somebody is buying 1 kilo, so how much the difference? 500 kd? I don't think he will give you a difference 500 kd.
Because they have a justification saying we bought it at a higher price, so we are getting a loss.
So we want to keep it. Nobody else is selling coins.
Only few shops are selling coins.
Allah Alam.
That's
usually Egyptian people buy this. Usually Egyptian people buy this at the end of the year. In April or in May. Why? They buy, then they go to their vacation in Egypt. So, Allah Alam about this case. Yeah.